In this video, we discuss changes in the wavelength of light when it changes from one medium to another. Then we work a simple example showing how to calculate the wavelength of light in a medium. To start things out, we visualize light waves in a vacuum as transverse waves on a string. Light traveling on the direction of a light ray can be visualized as a simple wave train, like we see in the first animation on the upper left. Note that I've marked a point on the string that's oscillating up and down. The frequency of oscillation of that point is what we mean by the frequency for the wave. So we can write down for light traveling in a vacuum, the speed is equal to c, the speed of light. The wavelength is lambda. For frequency, we'll use an f. And remember, the wave speed equation says v equals f lambda. The speed with which this wave propagates is given by multiplying frequency and wavelength. Well, in this case, that means c is equal to f lambda. Or I could say the wavelength is c over f. But what happens to this light wave if it enters a medium, say glass? First, we already know the wave will effectively slow down by a factor of n, the index of refraction, and I'll post a link real quick to the video where this was first discussed. So the speed is reduced, but notice that the frequency of the wave doesn't change. Again, we're tracking that white spot on the wave and watching it go up and down. The frequency of the light in a vacuum is exactly the same as the frequency of the light when it propagates into the material. Making an analogy to waves on a string, we visualize the transition of light from the fast to slow medium by tying a light string to a heavy string, and that white dot is the knot between the two strings. And of course, it's wiggling up and down at the same rate for each of these waves, otherwise the string would be broken. All right, so everywhere in the wave, the frequency is the same. But what changes here? I can see in the picture, it appears to be the wavelength that changes. So if you have a smaller speed and the frequency stays the same, looking at v equals f lambda, it must be lambda that got smaller to explain that decrease in the velocity. So we can replace the new wave speed with c over n and solve for lambda prime. And then I realized that c over f, that was our original wavelength in a vacuum. So I arrive at this really useful formula. The wavelength of light in a medium is equal to the wavelength in a vacuum divided by the index of refraction. For the sake of completeness, on the bottom right-hand side, we have a transition from a slow medium to a fast medium. And again, what's changing here is not the frequency. I can see the frequency of each wiggle is the same by watching that white dot at the interface between the two materials. And it's just the wavelength that changes when the speed changes. So no matter what transitions occur as a light wave is passing through different media, the frequency is the thing that stays the same. And then the wavelength in any particular medium is just given by this simple formula, the wavelength in vacuum divided by the index of refraction. Let's wrap things up with a simple example. So we have red light with wavelength 650 nanometers entering a slab of crown glass. The index of refraction is given to us as 1.52, and we want the wavelength of this light in the crown glass. So there's not a lot to do here. I take my original wavelength, which is assumed to either be in vacuum or in air, which is a close enough approximation, 650 nanometers, and divide by my index of refraction to 3 sig figs, I get 428 nanometers for the wavelength of this light within the glass. And we're done with the example. So I want to make a quick comment on this because I've seen a lot of videos that do something wrong at this point. So this red light had a wavelength of 650 nanometers. Now it has a wavelength of 428 nanometers. Does that mean this is somehow violet light when it's traveling inside the glass? If I were able to put my eye inside the glass, would I see purple instead of red? And the answer is no. It's the frequency that matters, because when the light travels into your eye, it's always going to end up with whatever wavelength 650 nanometer red light ends up with when it's inside the fluid in your eye. So it's still the same frequency of wiggling for the light. It's the same wavelength for the light within the fluid in your eye. You're going to detect red regardless of what medium you're in. All right, so now we know how light is transmitted at an interface between two media. In the next video, we're going to discuss reflections for light at an interface. If you find the physics content on Zach's Lab helpful, click on the Zach's Lab logo on the right to browse playlists and subscribe to the channel. I produce over 100 new videos per month, and subscribing is the easiest way to find new content. Thanks for watching.